I can't believe it happened to me. I am the most cynical person in the world when I hear about these things.
Even savvy seniors like Patricia are in for a shock. She discovered just how sophisticated scams are today.
The day that this incident occurred, I was in a hurry, and I was trying to contact Comcast about discontinuing a digital box. So I got on the computer and looked it up on Google, which is what I do occasionally, you know, when I'm trying to find a phone number.
Sven Nelson with the Pierce County Prosecutor's Office says telephone scams target seniors because they almost always answer their phones. And in cases like Patricia, her scam started on the internet.
Some of them shy away from the internet, but the ones that are on it, they are easily also confused by spoofed websites and so forth, which looks like a legitimate thing.
A customer service rep answered, and he seemed to know my name. He said, well, are you aware that there are people in Mexico and Russia that are also listed on your account? And they have access to your social security number, and they are using it to open up other accounts. I kind of went into panic mode, and I said, how is this possible?
Just because a scammer calls you and tells you that your number's in jeopardy, that's often them fishing for that information. Let me verify your social security number. Can you give it to me?
And he said, well, you'll have to get a money order for $500. At this point, Lauren had come into the kitchen while I was talking on the phone and said, you need to get off the phone. This is a scam. So I was immensely relieved to find out that none of this was true. And also relieved because I hadn't actually mailed the $500.
Nelson says your social security number should be kept secret. Don't carry your card in your wallet and don't give it out to anyone.
Once the scammers get a hold of that social security number, they can open up bank accounts, loans, they can do all kinds of things that the victim never even knows about until some credit report comes or bills start coming in the mail. They can also file people's tax returns for them and collect that before the senior does.
In a different example, Nick Gole was looking for an apartment on Craigslist and soon discovered the ad he liked was a scam.
I was led to believe I was going to share an apartment with another person. They wanted $1,000 for a deposit, you know, and then they didn't even want to give me a key to the apartment. And further investigation, we discovered that the apartment really did not exist.
Don't delay. Once you've figured out something is wrong, take the steps that day.
I felt that this must be something that is happening to a lot of senior citizens who are being taken advantage of because we have low income and because we're old, and because we're old, people think that we're stupid.
There's a lot of embarrassment that happens when you're scammed, and nobody wants to admit that to the family. Some family members think, well, what's wrong with mom or dad? Why are they not thinking clearly at this point? And so that just makes it worse, and so they hide it. And then the scammers keep scamming, because once they have a little bit of taste of the money coming in, they're going to keep at it.
Greg McClellan for Aging Wisely.